Hi everybody, my name is Minwe and we are the best M&T group. And today we're going to talk about our acoustic legislator. With me, Minwe, I have first up, Jim. Next, we have Rao Cheng. And Ariel. So now Rao Cheng is going to go through with us the physics behind the acoustic levitator. See you.
Okay, so today we'll talk about acoustic levitation. So how it works is this. First of all, if I have a speaker, right, it will emit sound wave like that. Okay? Then it hits this reflector. Then it will get reflected backwards. Okay? So these two waves, right, the emitting and the reflecting wave, right, will interfere with one another. In the end, it will form like this. It will form a standing wave. Yay! And then because of standing wave, right, there's these nodal positions. Where there's no change in pressure, and hence we can actually suspend things here.
So hi everyone, so back to M&T. Now we're back at the M&T sweatshop. We're gonna look at all our workers.
Oh, 今天 sibei re.
Order 238.
I'm earning minimum wage, bro. I'm earning minimum wage. No money, eh.
Child labor.
So as you can see, we're all hard at work. And we all love soldering. So, see you in 1 year. Bye bye. Hello, so now we're end to our M&T of our 3 months of hard work. Say hi, everybody. So, our question for all of them. Will you all do this again? I guess you all know the answer. Bye bye.
Seconds later. One eternity later.
The gyroscope allows the drone to move freely in all directions, opening the door to many applications. Due to the extra lift provided by the helium, you can save power by at least 25%. Introducing HERO, our power-saving gyro for drones. Greater surveillance power. More precious memories of your loved ones. Our product comprises helium balloons attached to a foam gyroscope, which can be customized to suit your drone.
Hi, I'm a drone hobbyist, and I know how difficult and scary flying your custom-made drone can be. Back when I first flew my own drone, it went a little like this.
Oh my god! Whoops!
Are you? GG!
Look at that damage! So much damage!
Any of these familiar to you? Struggling to practice drone flying in fear of crashing? Well, fret not, because we at JJPL have the solution for you. Featuring Hilda, a modular add-on to almost any drone that gives it anti-collision properties. It's quick and simple to remove or add on to your drone. Hilda replaces your remote control and receiver and introduces sensors to provide the anti-collision capabilities.
To ensure good connection allowing ease of controlling the drone, we have developed and designed a printed circuit board for the remote control.
We're using ultrasound sensors to sense the drone's surroundings, which can work both indoors and outdoors. The data from the sensors is then used by our microcontroller to alter the drone's movement to prevent a collision. We use the lightweight Arduino Nano microcontroller, which minimizes the additional thrust required to lift the drone.
We tested our system on our own amateur self-built drone using standard hobbyist hardware. Notably, we're using a simple APM 2.8 flight controller, 4-in-1 ESC for compact wiring, as well as 3D printed landing gears.
And here are the results.
So place your order today and make drone flying a safer experience. Hilda, helping!
Idiots!
Ham! Drones!
Again! As a physics major, I'm always using complicated data analysis software to process the data from my experiments. No one really taught us how to use the software, and a lot of time was wasted just trying to get the software set up so that we can get the correct sensor data. Because of this, I wanted to make an easier to use system that people without any training could use.
Venturing into this project, I mean, knew next to nothing about networking. Learning everything from scratch meant a lot of frustration when it came to troubleshooting. Learning about the hardware and software was just a start. We also had to learn how these two work together. But slowly piecing all these things was both frustrating but fun and fulfilling at the same time.
With 285 million people in the world who are blind, there is a strong need for this device, thus we have decided to create it.
Helping the blind community is our privilege.
Our device helps the blind man cross the road independently. This is something that is not blind.
This device would be useful when there's no light, no sound.
Not all the lights are equipped with the heart scanner, which will turn the sound on after 9 p.m.
Let's know, I'm very excited for this also.
I didn't actually think that they would be interested in our project, but when we went down to interview them, they were actually quite excited about it. It's nice.
Oh my God!
things we used to do and used to be. I could be the one to make you feel that way. I could be the one to set you free. Do you think about me when the crowd is gone? It used to be so easy, you and me.
Trying to get the right angle so that when I release this ball, you hit the right tile and you play the note.
Oh, you got 3 points.
Now, let us find out more about the Bouncing Ball Musical Box. Our project aims to develop a fun, educational, and musical platform for users of all ages to learn about projectile motion. Our box comes in 4 different components, namely the 3D printed box, ramp and rail system, the individual key element, as well as the electronics comprising of an LCD screen and a speaker. First off, we have a 3D printed box, which houses a total of 125 individual key elements, both of which are enclosed within an acrylic box. Each individual key element has a piezo sensor directly attached to them, which are then wired up to our electronic components via an external breadboard. We also have a metal cage that skirts the edges of the acrylic box and supports an easily detachable ramp that allows for 3 degrees of freedom, which can be measured from the instruments on board it. Combine everything and we have the Bouncing Ball Musical Box.
Thank you.